Welcome, my dear learners, for this course on operations research. In our module 2, we were discussing about analytical solutions for linear programming problems. In our previous two lectures, we have discussed how to solve linear programming problems using simplex method. In today's lecture, we are heading to solve problems on Big M method. In our previous two lectures, we have already solved problems on simplex method. The careful observation what we had is that in case of simplex method, the constraints will always given in such a way that the LHS is always less than or equal to the RHS, and we'll be using only slack variables to convert these constraints into set of linear equations. Whereas if the constraints are given as greater than or equal to or equal to, in such cases we are forced to introduce surplus variables. When we are forced to introduce the surplus variables, we cannot solve the problem using simplex method. So therefore, we should move on and solve the problem by using either two-phase method or using Big M method, which is also termed as penalty approach. Big M method is also called as penalty method. In case of Big M method or penalty method, if you have the constraint as greater than or equal to or equal to, then we should introduce the surplus variables. If I introduce the surplus variables, the careful observation on the first iteration matrix of simplex method, these matrix having the slack or surplus variables will not become the identity matrix. What I mean to say is that if you have gone through the lecture 1 and lecture 2 of this series on module 2, in which we are discussing linear programming problems, we have, for both the problems 1 and 2 which we have discussed, we have introduced the slack variables and we have 3 constraints. So therefore, we have introduced 3 slack variables. So if I observe the first matrix, let us say I have a slack variables S1, S2, S3 to the corresponding constraints, then the first row will have 1 and it does not contain any other slack variables S2 and S3, whereas the second linear equations will have S2, it won't contain S1 and S3, whereas the third linear equation will have S3, it won't contain S2 and S1. So therefore, if you clearly observe, it gives us the identity matrix. If in case we introduce the surplus variable, which I clearly explained in our lecture 1, the difference between slack variable and surplus variable, surplus variable coefficient will become -1. So if we use surplus variable, then the surplus variable will be, let us take the first, or let us take these two constraints and convert them into linear equations. If I take these two constraints, if you observe, we get x1 plus 4x2 plus 2x3 minus s1. Now since I am subtracting, this s will become the surplus variable and this will be equal to 8. Similarly, 3x1 plus 2x2 minus s2 is equal to 6. Since I am subtracting the reduced variable, this also will become surplus variable. So this is a case for slack variables. Which we have solved in simplex method, where in which we have solved two problems in our lecture 1 and lecture 2. So now, if I write this in matrix form and if I observe only for the introduced variables, then I can observe S1 and S2 as, for equation 1 I have S1, I don't have S2, whereas for equation 2 I have only S2, I don't have S1, but a careful observation states that the coefficients are -1. Since we have -1 and -1, this does not represent the identity matrix. And if I have the slack and surplus mixed combination, I will get -1 plus 1, -1 plus 1, like that. So therefore, we won't get the identity matrix for introduced variables. Whereas if I have only slack variables, I will get the identity matrix. Hence, in order to overcome this difficulty, so if you won't have the identity matrix, then the basic feasible solution will not be obtained for the given linear programming problem. In order to overcome this difficulty, we will be introducing a fictitious variable known as artificial variable. Therefore, whenever you use surplus variable, introduce the artificial variable along with it. So if you introduce the artificial variable along with it, then the variables can be represented in terms of identity matrix in the first simplex method table. What I mean to say is that whenever you are using the surplus variable, that is for big M method or for two-phase method or for any other methods, if you are introducing slack variable, when the condition is less than or equal to, then no need to worry, you will be adding S1 alone. Now, whenever you have a situation like introduction of surplus variables, it is a situation where in which we have greater than or equal to sign, you should add minus S1 plus A1. So this is because of the reason to obtain the identity matrix, whereas if I have surplus, I won't get the identity matrix. So this one more variable what we are introducing is termed as artificial variable. Artificial variable. Now, whenever you have only artificial variable, that is, whenever you encounter a case having sign only is equal to sign, only artificial variables are introduced when you have only is equal to sign in the constraints, then add artificial variable A1 alone. Whereas this is what we have for simplex methods, only less than or equal to constraints. For this problem, we observe we have surplus variable requirement because we have the constraint as greater than or equal to, therefore I should subtract the surplus variable. In order to get the identity matrix of the introduced variable, I should add artificial variable along with it. Now, to solve the problems in big M method, for minimization problems, use the coefficient of artificial variable as plus M, which is nothing but the penalty in the objective function. For maximization problems, use the coefficient of artificial variable as minus M in the objective function. That is, in this equation we used to write plus 0s1 plus 0s2, but for artificial variables you should write it as plus ma1 for minimization problem, minus ma1 for maximization problems. In order to avoid these confusions, let us solve all the problems in terms of maximization itself, or objective is to maximize the objective function. So whenever you have the minimization problems, I already explained in our lecture 1 itself how to convert the minimization problem into maximization problems just by multiplying negative side in both LHS and RHS. So therefore, always the objective function is taken as maximization. If not, convert it and solve. So if they have given you the problem to minimize the given objective function, then convert it for the maximization problem and then solve. That is, multiply negative sign on both sides. So if I multiply negative sign on both sides, since this is a minimization problem, multiplying negative sign on both sides, I will convert this function into maximization problem. If I convert that into maximization problem, I should introduce the coefficient of artificial variable as minus f in the objective function. And also, one should remember these conditions to solve the problems on any given method to convert the constraints into set of linear equations. So this we have already thoroughly studied in our lecture 1 and lecture 2, how to handle the slack variable. So now we will be dealing with surplus variable and artificial variable. And why we are using this big M, a large value which is known as penalty. Hence this big M method is also called as penalty method. We are adding the penalty for this, or we are multiplying the penalty for this artificial variable only because of the reason we will ensure that it will move out of the matrix, thereby we will get the optimization of the given problem, or we will get the solution required for the given problem by eliminating the artificial variable out of the matrix. But to eliminate the artificial variable out of the simplex matrix, we are introducing the penalty along with it, which is denoted by big M. So hence the name big M method is also termed as penalty method. So big M method or penalty method. Hope it is clear why we are introducing artificial variable along with surplus variable. This is because of the reason I should get the identity matrix if I write the introduced variables matrix separately. You have to ensure that I will get the basic physical solution. And why we are multiplying the big M, which is nothing but a penalty along with the artificial variable in the objective function, is that ensure that the artificial variables are moved out of the matrix in the final stage of the simplex method, so that I will get the optimized results or the solution for the given problem. With this very brief introduction to penalty method or big M method, let us solve our first problem on penalty method. The problem number 3 of our discussion on analytical solutions for linear programming problems states that solve the following linear programming problem by big M method. Minimize z is equal to 2x1 plus 3x2 plus x3. Substitute to x1 plus 4x2 plus 2x3 greater than or equal to 8. 3x1 plus 2x2 greater than or equal to 6. x1 comma x2 are positive values. The first step is that we should represent the given linear programming model in its standard form. Let us represent it in its standard form by knowing the procedure to handle the slack and surplus variables and also the artificial variables. Let us represent it in standard form. Since it is a minimization problem, let us solve all the problems by default in the maximization to avoid the confusion. So therefore, convert the given problem into maximization by multiplying negative sign on both sides. So therefore, if I do that, I will get maximize minus of z is equal to minus 2x1 minus 3x2 minus x3, subjected to x1 plus 4x2 plus 2x3. Since I have greater than or equal to sign, I should add minus s1 plus a1. Here s1 is the surplus variables because I am subtracting. This will be equal to 8. And next we have 3x1 plus 2x2 minus s2 plus a2. Since I am using surplus, I should also introduce the artificial variable. This will be equal to 6. And coming for the positive constraints, we will be having x1 comma x2 comma x3 comma s1 comma S2, comma A1, comma A2 are all greater than or equal to 0. Now, in case of simplex method, in the first step, the basic variables are slack variables. Whereas, in any other techniques other than simplex method, you should use only slack variables and artificial variables as the basic variables. Wherever you have slack variables, take it as a basic variable. Wherever you have surplus variable, take artificial variable as the basic variable. This is to ensure that you will get the basic feasible solution. Because whenever you introduce the surplus variable, along with it, by default, we will introduce the artificial variable. So therefore, for the basic variable column, you always use artificial variable whenever you have the surplus variable along with it. Or the artificial variable will be introduced whenever you have the surplus variables. Let us solve this problem. The first simplex matrix will be, you will be having basic variable. Let us take it as iteration number 1. We have basic variable, their coefficients, that is CB, and we have the RHS, that is XB, and the variables what we have for this problem are listed down here: x1, x2, x3, s1, s2, a1, a2. They are x1, x2, x3, s1, s2, a1, a2. And I should calculate the minimum ratio of xp by xk and perform row operations. Now, I already said this S1 and S2 are surplus variables, so therefore I should not introduce these surplus variables to basic variables. Instead of surplus variables, I should use artificial variables. So therefore, using artificial variables, I will get the basic variables as A1 and A2. If this S1 and S2 are slack variables, in that case, take the slack variable into the basic variables column. Or if I have S1, S2, S3, where S3 is the slack variable, then the basic variable column will be A1, A2, S3, because S3 is slack. And considering the values, let me complete the objective function. Since we have the artificial variables and surplus variables, the continuing the objective function, I get. So now we have S1, so therefore it will become plus 0 S1, and we have S2 as the surplus, it will become 0 S2. So just now I have explained, whenever we are solving the problem on maximization, I should give the coefficient as minus m for artificial variable. Whenever I am solving the problems on minimization, I should give plus m as the coefficient for artificial variable. In order to avoid confusion, we are solving problems on maximization only. If it gives the problem as minimization, we will convert it into maximization by multiplying negative sign on both sides. That is what I have done here. So since the problem is maximization, I should give the coefficient as minus m for artificial variables. Since we have two artificial variables, I will get minus ma1 minus ma2. So this is a required objective function for the given problem. Now, representing this in matrix form, the variables what we have are x1, x2, x3, s1, s2, a1, a2. Now the coefficient of x1 from first linear equation 1, coefficient of x2 is 4, x3 is 2, s1 is minus 1, s2 is 0, a1 is plus 1, a2 is 0. Coming for the second linear equation, x1 coefficient is 3, x2 coefficient is 2, we don't have x3, put 0, we don't have s1, put 0, s2 is minus 1, we don't have a1, we have a2, put it as 1. So this is equal to 8 and 6. So this is a matrix representation of, matrix representation of the set of linear equations. What I have. So therefore, we have the variables x1, x2, x3, s1, a1, a2. So now, above xv, I should write it as ci and enter the coefficients of these variables in the objective function. So in the objective function, the coefficients are minus 2, minus 3, minus 1, 0, 0, minus m, and minus m. So now the coefficients of artificial variables are minus m and minus m. Now this xb is already known to us. Xb is nothing but the RHS of the linear equations, which we have from the constraints given, that is 8 and 6. So therefore, if I write, I get 8 and 6. So now from x1 to a2, we have the matrix form, pick it and place it here. So if I do that, I get 1, 4, 2 minus 1, 0, 1, 0, 3, 2, 0, 0, minus 1, 0 and 1. Since the variables are very lengthy, we have more variables, no need to show them. That is, we don't have x1, x2, x3, s1, s2 as the basic variables. They will be treated as 0 initially. Since we have more variables, no need to show it. By default, we understood that the coefficients are the values of these x1, x2, x3, s1, s2 are treated as 0 initially, and when we proceed, we will find out the values of x1, x2, x3 which is required. So instead of that, directly we will write the formula for z. The formula for z is known to us. Z is equal to summation of CBXB. If you clearly observe, in case of simplex method, the value of Z for the first matrix is equal to 0. That is because of the reason the coefficients of slack variables are 0. But here, the coefficients of artificial variables are minus m and minus m. So therefore, minus 8m, minus 6m will give us the value as minus 14m. So now we should write the value of delta I, which is equal to zi minus ci. Whereas for simplex method, since cb is 0, zi will be 0, so therefore delta I is nothing but minus c. Cn. But here the careful observation is that the Zi is not equal to 0. We know that the formula for Zi is summation of Cv Xi. So therefore, if I do it for the x1, let me take it as first column for our understanding. So Cb Xi, Cb is minus m into 1, so I have minus m into 1 plus minus m into 3, minus m into 3, minus Ci, Ci is nothing but above x1 we have minus 2. So therefore delta 1 will be minus m minus 3m, I will get minus 4m plus 2. So I will get minus 4m plus 2. Similarly calculate for x2, let me take it as delta 2, I have minus m into 4 plus minus m into 2 minus Ci, Ci is minus 3. So therefore delta 2 will become minus 4 minus 2 is minus 6, minus 6m plus 3. Let me do for delta 3, I have minus m into 2 plus 0 minus of minus 1, so the value will be minus 2m plus 1. Coming over here, minus m into minus m is plus m, plus m 0, so you get plus m. Coming over here, minus m into minus 1 is plus m, here also you get minus m and minus m, following the same procedure. Now onwards the procedure remains same. Identify the most negative value of delta I. M is the very large value, so therefore minus 6m will be the very huge value, so therefore minus 6m plus 3 is the most negative delta I. So therefore this will be the incoming vector, and calculate the minimum ratio of xp by xk. Now it will become xp by x2. So the most negative is minus 6 plus 3 is the most negative of delta I. Of all delta I, minus 6m plus 3 is the most negative. So therefore this will be the incoming vector, that is x2. To calculate the outgoing vector, calculate the ratio, that is xp by x3, that is 8 by 4 which is equal to 2, 6 by 2 which is equal to 3. So therefore this is the minimum, so the key element will be 4. 4 is the key element and first row is moving out of the matrix. Let us treat these as row 1, row 2 and row 3 without primes. Now we already know the procedure. I should make this key element as unity, and using this key row I should make these two elements as 0. I should do that until I'll get all the delta I values as positive or greater than or equal to 0. Let us do that. Now moving for the second iteration, that is iteration number 2, we have a1 is moving out and x2 is coming in. So therefore the basic variable will be x2 in the position of a1, and a2 the artificial variable is unaltered, and coming for the coefficients cb, the coefficient of x2 is minus 3 in the objective function, and the coefficient of a2 is minus m in the objective function. And also, if you calculate the value of delta for a1 and a2, that is delta of a1 is equal to z is nothing but summation of cbxi minus ca. So cb is minus m, minus m into 1 is plus minus m into 0. Minus of minus m is equal to minus m plus m is equal to 0. Sorry, we have done a mistake here. So correct the value of delta for a1 and a2. It is 0 and 0, not m and m. M and m is for s1 and s2, that is for surplus variables. Kindly correct it. Now let me formulate the table first and perform the row operation from xb to a2. If I do that, now performing the row operation, we know that this is the key row for us and this key element should be unity for the next iteration. So therefore, to make this key element as unity, this key row must be closed divided by 4. So therefore, the new row 1 dash will be equal to old row 1 whole divided by 4. So if I do that, I should perform the row operation from xb to a2. I will get 8 by 4 is 2, 1 by 4, 1, that is what I require, 2 by 4 is 1 by 2, minus 1 by 4, 0 by anything is 0, 1 by 4, 0 by anything is 0. Now I should make this element as 0 and this element as 0 by using this key row in our new iteration. So therefore, here I have 2. So therefore, the new R2 dash will become old R2 minus 2 times new R1, that is R1 dash. By that, I can make it as 0. And here we have minus 6m plus 3. So therefore, R3 new R3 dash is equal to old R3. I have plus 6, minus 6m, so therefore I want plus 6m. I have plus 3, so therefore I want minus 3 multiplied by new R1, that is R1 dash. So now performing the row operation, we have here 6. 6 minus 2 into 2 is 4. 6 minus 4 is, again we will get the value as 2. Here we have 3. 3 minus 2 by 4 is 3 minus 1 by 2. So 3 minus 1 by 2 is 5 by 2. Next, here we have 2. 2 minus 2 into 1 is equal to 0. That is what I require. Based on that only I have written. This will also be 0. Now here we have 0. 0 minus 2 by 2 will become minus 1. Here we have 0. 0 minus 2 of minus 1 by 4. That is minus of minus is plus 2 by 4. That is plus 1 by 2. Here I have minus 1, here I have 0, so therefore it will become minus 1 only. here I have 0, here I have 1 by 4, so therefore minus 2 by 4 is minus 1 by 2. Here I have 1, but here I have 0, so therefore it will become 1. Now coming for the last third row, we have here old R3 is minus 14m plus 6m minus 3 of new R1 is 2. So if I do that, I get minus 14m plus 12m minus 6, that is minus 2m minus 6. So I'll get minus 2m minus 6, that is 3 2s are 6, 2m, that is correct. It is valid from the formula summation of CBXB also. Now coming for this one, we have minus 4m plus 2 plus 6m minus 3 of R1 is 1 by 4. So if I do that, I'll get minus 4m plus 2 plus 3m by 2 minus 3 by 4. So I'll get the value as minus 4 plus 3 by 2 is minus 5 by 2. M 2 minus 3 by 4 will give us 5 by 4 plus 5 by 4. Minus 4 plus 3 by 2 is minus 5 by 2. M 2 minus 3 by 4 is 5 by 4. So I will get the value as minus 5 by 2 M plus 5 by 4. Next, moving over here, we have minus 2m plus 1 plus 6m minus 3 into R1 is 1 by 2. So therefore, I will get the value as minus 2m plus 3m minus 3 by 2. So I will get the value as plus 1. So I will get the value as M 1 minus 3 by 2 reduces minus 1 by 2. So M minus 1 by 2. Next, we have the value as M. So therefore, M plus 6M minus 3, and the value of R1 is minus 1 by 4. Minus 1 by 4, I will get the value as M minus 3M by 2 minus 3 by 4. So it is 1 minus 3 by 2 is nothing but minus 1 by 2 M minus 3 by 4. Minus 1 by 2 minus 3 by, minus of minus is plus, plus 3 by 4 is, so if we take 4 as LCM, we get the value as 3 minus 2m by 4. Taking 4 as LCM, I will get the value as 3 minus 2m by 4. Next, coming over here, we have m, but here we have 0. So therefore, I will get the value as m itself. Now here we have 0. Here also we have 0. So here 0, here also 0, therefore I will get 0 here. But here I will get the value. It is 1 by 4 times the 6m minus 4 minus 3. So therefore, 6m by 4 is 3m by 2 minus 3 by 4. 3m by 2 minus 3 by 4 is what we are getting. So if I simplify by taking 4 as LCM, I will get the value as 6m minus 3 by 4. So taking 4 as LCM, so if I write it directly, I'll get 6m minus 3 by 4. So this completes the third row which is required. Now if you observe, the most negative value is minus 5 by 2m. Apart from that, the negative value we have is minus 2m by 4. So minus 2m by 4 will give us minus 0.5m, whereas here we will get the value as minus 1.5m, so 2.5m, 5 by 2. So therefore, among this deltas, minus 5 by 2m is the most negative value which gives us the incoming vector. So therefore, the incoming vector is x1. So x1 is the incoming vector, and also since m is the very large value which is termed as penalty, always check for maximum m. Only you should check for m here. So if I check for m, we have m here which is positive, leave it. If I check m here, it is positive, leave it. M here, positive, leave it. So therefore, I should check only for these two. If I check for these two, I will get minus 5 by 2m and minus 2 by 4m. Among this, the most negative is minus 5 by 2m. So therefore, this is the incoming vector. Now to calculate the outgoing vector, take the minimum ratio of xp by xk. If I take the minimum ratio of xp by xk, I will get the ratio of xp by x1. So the ratio of xp by x1, if I do, I will get the value as 2 divided by 1 by 4, which gives us the value as 8, and 2 divided by 5 by 2, which gives us the value as 4 by 5. Among 8 and 4 by 5, 4 by 5 is the minimum value. So therefore, the outgoing vector is A2. So A2 is the outgoing vector. Here we have calculated the values of delta I. We have not performed zi minus ci, just we have calculated based on the row operation. So this completes our iteration number 2. Since still we have the negative values of delta, the problem proceeds. Let us move on for iteration number 3. Moving on for iteration number 3. So in iteration 3, we will be getting x2 remains same. Instead of a2, we have x1 coming in. Coming for the coefficients, coefficient of x2 is minus 3 in the objective function, and coefficient of x1 is minus 2 in the objective function. Let me complete the table. Now we know that for us the key element is 5 by 2 and the key row is row 2. So therefore, first I should make this key element as unity and consider that key row for operation. So therefore, to make this key element as unity, I should divide this row throughout by 5 by 2 and I should perform the row operation from xb to a2. That is, the new row 2 double prime is equal to old row 2 throughout divided by 5 by 2. So which gives us the key row for iteration number 3. So old row 2 is row 2 dash, that is row 2 of iteration number 2. So if I do that, it will become 4 by 5. Here it will become unity, that is what I require. 0 and anything is 0, minus 2 by 5, so 2 will get cancelled, it will become 1 by 5, here I will get minus 2 by 5, here I will get minus 1 by 5, here I will get 2 by 5. Now, this value should be made as 0 and this value should be made as 0. So based on that, I should write the row operation. To make this as 0, the new row 1, that is R1 double dash, is equal to R1 dash previous value. I have plus 1 by 4, so therefore I should make it as minus 1 by 4 times the new row 2, that is key row R2 double dash. Now coming for this element, I should make it as 0, so therefore new row 3, that is R3 double dash, is equal to previous row 3, that is R3 dash minus 5 by 2, so therefore I should add plus 5 by 2 m plus 5 by 4, so therefore I should make it as minus 5 by 4 times R2 double dash. So times the R2 double dash. So if I do that, I'll get these two values as 0. Let me perform the row operation. So I have 2. So 2 minus 1 by 4 times R2 double dash is 4 by 5. 4 by 5, which gives us the value as 9 by 5. Here I have 1, here I have 0, so therefore we will get it as 1. Here I have 1 by 2, so here I have the value as minus 2 by 5, so therefore it is 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4 into minus 2 by 5. I will get the value as 3 by 5. Here I have 1 minus 1 by 4, here I have 1 by 5, so therefore it is minus 1 by 4 minus 1 by 4 into 1 by 5. I will get the value as minus 3 by 10. Here it is already 0, so therefore if I solve here, I will get the value as 0 minus 1 by 4 into R2 double x is minus 2 by 5. I will get the value as 1 by 10. So here we will get the value as plus 3 by 10. Let me verify. 1 by 4 minus 1 by 4 times minus 1 by 5. Yes, we will get the value as plus 3 by 10. And we have the value as 0, but here we have 2 by 5, so therefore I get the value as minus 2 by 5. Sorry, minus. For minus 2 by 5, we have the value as 1 by 10 with 0. For plus 2 by 5 with 0, we get the value as minus 1 by 10. So this completes the row operation of R1 and R2. Now I should perform the row operation for row 3. So we have the value of z is equal to summation of CBXP should satisfy. Now if I perform, let me perform it. So previous value is minus 2m minus 6, minus 2m minus 6 plus 5 by 2m minus 5 by 4 times R2 double dash is 4 by 5. So I will get the value as minus 2m plus 2m minus 6 minus 1, so therefore I get the value as minus 7. So z is equal to minus 7. We have converted the minimization to maximization problem, so therefore let me treat it as z dash minus of z dash and z dash. Next, here we get the value as 0, here I have 0 and here also I have 0, so therefore this will become 0. Here I have m minus 1 by 2, so therefore m minus 1 by 2 plus 5 by 2m minus 5 by 4 times minus 2 by 5. So if I solve, I will get the value as m minus m minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. So it gives us the value as 0. Next, coming over here, we have 3 minus 2m by 4. 3 minus 2m by 4 plus 5 by 2m minus 5 by 4 times 1 by 5. So I'll get minus 2 minus 2 by 4 minus 2 by 4 plus 1 by 2. So mm will get cancelled. And coming for the digits, we have 3 by 4 minus 1 by 4 1 by 2. So we'll get the value as 1 by 2. Next, coming for this one, we have m, here we have minus 2 by 5. So if it's performed, I'll get the value as m plus 5 by 2m minus 5 by 4 multiplied by minus 2 by 5. So if I perform 5 by 2, 2 by 5 will get cancelled. M minus m is 0, minus of minus is plus, 5 5 will get cancelled, I will get the value as 1 by 2. Next, doing for this one, we have 6m minus 3 by 4. So if I split it, I will get it as 3m by 2 minus 3 by 4 plus 5 by 2m minus 5 by 4 multiplied by minus 1 by 5. So if I perform, I will get the value as 3m by 2 minus 1 by 2. So get the value as m minus 3 by 4 minus of minus is plus 1 by 4 minus 1 by 2. Next, finally we have the value as 0 and 2 by 5. So therefore, multiplying 2 by 5 to that, I'll get the value as m minus 1 by 2. So if you clearly observe, all the values are positive. As I said, m is a very large value. From very large value, if you subtract only 0.5, it is positive only. Here also it will be remain same. So now we can understand why we have taken the coefficient of artificial variable as minus m, in order to get rid of the A2 completely from the final step of the simplex matrix. So if you observe, if I won't take the value as m as the coefficient for artificial variable, now minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2, again artificial variable will enter the matrix and the process will keep on going. So therefore, if you clearly observe, due to the use of very large value m, the A1 and A2 are moving out, they are terminated. In the final step, if you observe, all the values are positive, all the values of delta are positive here. So delta I is equal to Zi minus Ci. Since all the values of delta are positive in the final step, since all values of delta I are positive, greater than or equal to 0, from x1 to a2, all are positive, the problem terminates. Therefore, the solution for the problem is, the value of x2 is 9 by 5 and the value of x1 is 4 by 5. x2 is 9 by 5 and x1 is 4 by 5. So therefore, we have got the value of z dash as minus 7 we know that z is equal to minus of z, so therefore the value of z minimum is equal to minus of z, which is nothing but z prime. So therefore z minimum for this problem is plus 7. So the solution for the problem is 4 by 5, 9 by 5 and plus 7, not minus 7. Minus 7 is what we maximize the problem, but we should give solution for minimization. The answer is plus 7. If you want, you just substitute these values in this equation and verify. Since x3 has not at all entered the matrix, x3 is taken as 0. X3 is equal to 0. If I solve 2 times 9 by 5, 2 times 4 by 5 plus 3 times x2 is 9 by 5, I'll get the answer as 7. So therefore the answer is 7 and the values of x1 is 4 by 5, x2 is 9 by 5 and x3 is 0. So this is a complete solution for our first problem on Big M method or penalty method. That's all from this lecture. Thank you.